With cheap irons, you might get about 50 watts, 60 watts, 80 watts. With our entry-line unit, you have 135 watts. And thanks to our heating system, where we just heat from the very top of the tip, we're really good on keeping that temperature constant and reaching out temperature really fast. As you can see, if I lift the tool from the stand, it just takes about 3 seconds to heat up and reach desired temperature. We're a premium manufacturer of soldering equipment and rework equipment, and the company is based in Barcelona, Spain. Everything is manufactured in Europe. We have a 2-year warranty on all the products, and what JVC tries to do is we try to be ahead in terms of innovation. There are many different irons, right? There are many different brands, and you can go from a $15 soldering iron to a more expensive equipment. What's the difference, right? Because with $15 iron, maybe it does the job for you, but with a more expensive equipment, for example, with JVC equipment, what we have is that we have the thermocouple sensor right in the very top of the tip, so you have more control with our stations. We offer from prototype tips to we just released a traceability system where you can monitor all the stations from a computer. You can analyze all the data, you can download temperature graphs, power graph, and the main idea is that the operator will have a PCB on the board, and when they scan it, it's going to auto-set up the station. Wow. With the maximum temperature they can use, minimum, it's going to record everything. So if in 2 years you have a problem with one board, you will be able to trace back, see who was soldering that board, temperature he was working on, and all of that. Well, the thing is, JVC has regular irons, what most people knew as soldering iron, but we have two very special units. One is the nano station, for which we have the smallest tips in the market. We get to 0.1 millimeters in tip, and the main difference is you can get to 0.1 millimeters on diameter on the other soldering irons, but these ones are very thin, and the tool is very ergonomic, so it makes it really easy to rework one component without burning the one next to it, and very easy to see under the microscope as well. Apart from soldering equipment, we have rework equipment. So this, what you're looking at right now, is a hotter station, and there are many different in the market, right? What we have, what we always try to deliver to our customers, is that you have more control. So our station comes with a thermocouple. So what you can do is you can set up soldering profiles so you can heat up gradually and with control the temperature. And what we also have is what we call a protection and regulation mode. So you can stick this to any critical component, set a temperature, and make sure it doesn't go over that temperature and you don't overheat that component. Normally, as you said, traditionally people will use a wet sponge that will create a thermal shock into the tip. That's really bad for the tip. IPC doesn't recommend that. Or they will use the brass wool. The problem with the brass wool is that you get splashes. Sometimes you drag out solder, you clean on the same spot, it takes more time. And companies dealing with fault issues will have a problem with that. What we came out with is this nice tiny tip cleaner that has two brushes inside and a sensor. So it detects when you insert the tool and it starts automatically spinning, and it takes just 1 second in and out to clean the tip. It keeps everything inside and it keeps it clean fast. It's going to extend the life of the tip because it's not so aggressive with the tip. It just takes 1 second to clean it and there won't be any fault issues. So there are two very important things to be able to always keep on that level, that temperature constant. One is the heating system, and the other one is how powerful the unit is. With cheap irons, you might get about 50 watts, 60 watts, 80 watts. With our entry-line unit, you have 135 watts. And thanks to our heating system, where we just heat from the very top of the tip, we're really good on keeping that temperature constant and reaching out temperature really fast. As you can see, if I lift the tool from the stand, it just takes about 3 seconds to heat up and reach desired temperature.